What's up? Welcome. I'm really stoked about this article that got written about Songbringer by Ray Porecka. Porecka? I'm not sure how to say his last name. But I met him at PAX. He's a really cool guy. And I really, really love his writing style. I've read a few of his articles on here on Destructoid. And he's got a really intelligent way of writing. And I'm really stoked about how he just really got the message of Songbringer. Like the cactus, the meditation, and all that. So anyways, I'm going to post a link to this in the chat right now. But I'll be posting this again later on. What I'm working on today is the ending cutscenes. So this is a spoiler alert stream. You don't want to watch anymore if you don't want to spoil the plot of the game. This is the very final cutscenes I'm still working on. I'll probably be working on these the next couple days. So this is the one. So this is a long cutscene where you beat the final boss and there's a lot of things that happen. Now I'm down to this part where basically the tower becomes a ship. So it rises up into the air. So I'm tweaking things there. I've kind of got the scene already set up, like the structure of the scene, the timing of the movements in general, and things like that. It's just that now it's got to be really touched up. The artwork is kind of messed up. There's like a few really weird parts to the clouds I've got to fix. But yeah, that's what I'm working on. Let's get that wet. It's like backgrounds. Oh, I think it's scene tower rising. Yeah, here we go. All right, I saved this a little bit better than it. Yeah, it's like it has some extra light that I didn't render out yet. So let's see this whole sequence just as it is. You've got to imagine that the boss has already been defeated. I already want to see this without story verbosity. That's looking better already. Okay, so I need to separate out those layers too. So the tower needs to be a separate layer than the ground, because obviously the ground's not rising here. And the clouds need to parallax the entire time. So does the sky. And it probably needs to use exponential. Okay, so this bit, the duration of this whole scene is 20. So this is 20. And let's try exponential. All right, now the other bits. Okay, what's one? Scene tower rising. Zero's the star background. Ah, so one is those background clouds. Two background clouds. Three. One and two. Need to keep moving the entire time. Okay, so the foreground clouds can move down too. Which is going to be like four. Well, we're going to change this, the order from there out. But that would be four. Five. I think six is. Wait a minute. Okay, so I'm just making adjustments to the timing of this, of each one of these parallax layers, just to get this scene to look, right. Yeah, constant movement is a really nice thing. Okay, cool. So yeah, once I get okay, now the most important part is to render out the layers properly. So separate out the tower from the ground, and then the other most important bit is to basically render these all with different lighting and get the little spheres to line up right and stuff like that. So artwork, just gotta work on this scene here. This is not really like a painting type of artwork. This is more of just like a, I guess it is painting a little bit. But oh, it'd be nice to get this all done. I like this. This image is gonna be cool, this rising into the sky. All right. So the tower. Okay, that's the tower and the ground. Kind of like this original one better. What's up, Salad? Yeah, man. Yeah, this is really cool. Like somebody that, the feeling I get right now is something, I've been working on for this is the third year making Songbringer. So, it's years of life put into something, and then somebody really understands like the message you're trying to convey. So cool. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, really, it's a really fulfilling feeling. Yeah, totally, right? I'm excited to see it. I mean, yeah, it wouldn't be possible without so much help from everyone, That's the thing, like, once you open up what you do to create what you're creating to other people, like it's nice what other people contribute back to you, as long as you're kind of a cool person, As long as you be cool to people, people are cool to you. How you doing today? Right? Yeah, goodwill. That's the word for it. Doing pretty good. Awesome. So how are you going to go about that? Oh, a page of sketches of things. Oh, nice. Cool. So, what are you using? Paper and a pen or something, or paper and pencil? Oh, digital, right on. I know, right? It is. You're like, where did I stash that piece of paper? I know that feeling. Oh, right, backups too. So important. And I like revisions as well. So it's so cool to have like revisions of your artwork. So you're like, oh, what was it like back at like the first time I drew this? Boom. Think, oh man, I love Git. Love me some Git. Yeah, right. The right copy. Yeah, the feeling of worry you get when you're like, damn, all my artwork could be just destroyed at any minute. Thanks. Yeah, totally. I finally started using Git for my like bash RC and Vim stuff, Vim, all my Vim RC and all that. School notes and school notes and assignments. Wow, assignments? For real? Dang, you, that's, I wonder what that would be like. Like, I didn't have Git when I was in university or college, whatever you want to call it. We didn't really have Git then. We had like SVN, which was, you know, it's nowhere near as awesome as Git. SVN is like torturously slow now compared to Git. Oh, really? Oh yeah, commit, done, boom. Oh, that's a really good point. I should start using this more in my life. For right. Okay, let's see what this looks like. With the light. Git LFS, what's that? Is that large file system? Oh, large file support. Oh. Is that just some tweaks to your Git in your Git config? Oh, it's an add-on, a package? Oh. So what do you need to use it for? Like, what's it useful for? Right? Right? Oh. Right. Right, so how does it overcome that? Oh, okay, so it's a fundamental difference to how Git works. I see. But it's meant for those big binary compressed files. Ah, it sounds pretty smart. I wonder if they'll like integrate that into the main Git, the main Git. All right. Ah. Right. Cool. It sounds that really sounds like something they could really integrate into the basic Git. Nice. Thanks for auto hosting, everybody. I just gotta redo this. Oh yeah, might have. There's a lot of streamers that came up and got to play Songbringer at PAX, and some of them even had like crews. They were recording all their stuff with like a camera crew. Some of them had like little HD or little like USB sticks. They were recording everything at HD. It was available to be played on PlayStation 4. Xbox One and PC, so like we were showing it on all three platforms. So some people like got to play it on their preferred platform, which was really neat. You know, we should have kind of made a bigger deal out of that because it's a really awesome thing to have it already running on three platforms. It's pretty neat. Yeah. Yeah, so that's awesome. Thanks to Double 11, you know, they already have their awesome. They have an awesome custom engine written. So, you know, really the trick is just basically like throwing out as much stuff they don't need to use, like Cocos 2DX. Like, whoop, don't need that. You know, just use our engine in place. And then once you got that part set, you know, then it's, well, there's a lot more to do. But they're really cool. Yeah, Double 11's awesome. It's like a freaking dream come true, actually. It's like the best. This is the best deal. It's so great. Songbringer gets to be on like all these other platforms. Everybody's happy. All the players get to play it on whatever platform they can. They found me. So when I was doing the Kickstarter. Yeah. Uh-huh. So yeah, we kind of became aware of each other then. And then later on, I was like, well, this could be a really great thing. Yeah, uh-huh. Dang, these are a lot of clouds. Wow. All right. So this layer is almost finished. That is looking pretty good. So we want this background thing to be, what was it? Is this one only 9? Alright, so that's one layer of clouds better. Think maybe two layers. Kind of get away with this back one as it is. But this middle one here down just needs to be fixed up. Yo, Tiggs. What's up? How you doing today? What's up, man? Okay, so I'm gonna turn off the light, turn off all the layers except for this foreground layer of clouds. Doing stuff and things. Nice. Stuff and things. Ground. Yeah, so this layer has some crazy messed up clouds. Oh, you're gonna switch to Lua. Interesting. Wow. So what are the advantages? Cool. The engine's still Java, scripts are in Lua. Oh, easy to mod the engine. Oh, cool, man. Oh, it's 78%. Was like, why is this not drawing right? There. Aha. Was messing me up. In fact, let's make a new layer for this one. There, simpler. Okay, now I'll throw on some texturing. Looks pretty good. All these clouds. Let's merge all these. All right, so now we can apply this texturing to the clouds and also this coloring. And ooh, I forget what it was before. It's opacity, maybe like 30 though. And probably more. I don't remember. Let's find out. Turn everything on and see where it looks right. Oh, definitely more than that, yeah. The background maybe could use a little more opacity on the clouds texturing. All right, let's get this rendered and see how this is looking. I want to get to the point where he's animated too. I'm considering maybe taking these utmost foreground layer clouds and moving them in front of zero. What'd that look like? Yeah, that might actually be pretty cool. Yeah, I like that actually. Cool. Let's keep that up there. Gotta redo this. Whoa, wait a minute. Okay, got this document all ready to go, I think. Let's check it in though. As it is. All right, well, now time to render it all out. New files. Yeah, everything's got to change. Except for, well, yeah, even the background. All right. Turn off everything. Oh my God. Making this a timeline. Yes, someone have to render this separately every time. All right, there. Got it all set up. Start there. Next one. Oh, here it is. There we go. Oh man, I ruined it. What did I do? Probably this. Oh, this is just 100%. This isn't supposed to be 100. So we got light. This is kind of cleaned up. Now this can be used to animate this whole document. Oh, this is really nice doing this document this way because now it's just at a glance. I can see, this is the first frame, that's the second frame. And it's going to be so easy each time I want to export something new. Okay, so I've got a special layer for the tower. One of them is where the tower is on the ground, and the next one's where the tower is more up in the air. So hopefully that looks better with the document the way it is. This is actually two cutscenes, so it'll be like two different versions of the color for the tower, I'm thinking. So let's go the next thing. Next layer. Cool. Alright, so render that to scene tower rising overwrite. Okay, so now I gotta readjust everything. Let's go and switch back to mouse mode. All right, so we've got some different layers now. There's Tower Rising 0. Still 1, 2. And there's 3 is the ground. And then 4 is, oops, oh no. What happened to all these? Was freaking. They all got turned off because of some propagate frame one bullshit. I hate propagate frame one. Okay, so back to this. We have 4, but not 5, and 6, 7, 8. Wait, 4, but not 5. So now there's basically just two ground layers, which I think are these. What was scene number four? Yeah. So three is the ground. Let's see if it's anywhere near close. So just getting these all these layers to parallax correctly, applying all the right animations. And I still got to do an animation for zero there. Oh, the ground didn't move right. Does it? Oh, it's doing the ground upwards. No, it's supposed to go to the next layer. So that's here. Oh no, it's the Titanic. Everybody run for your lives. So wait, three is the ground? Oh, three and four need to be the same. Oh, so I messed up four. Try that. These things are kind of tedious bits of work. There's a lot of like little things just to get one cutscene like this working, where it's got a lot. The more parallax layers you have, the more complex it is. But hopefully it'll be worth it and it'll look really cool. Be like, sweet, this is a rad cutscene. Oh my god. The giant tower is a ship. What is this, Voltron? Yeah. So if the foreground clouds keep moving, keep going, foreground cloud, and the other foreground clouds need to move too. Okay, it looks really weird there at the end. Oh, that was funny. Oh, tons. Yeah, so much trial and error. So yeah, I think these can just keep moving throughout the last. So six is zero. Exponential out, exponential out. Let's see, this one's sine out. Oops, sine out. Oh yeah, I haven't even. That's from a different cutscene. I don't even know if it works. I haven't even listened once. I've been purely focused on the visuals. I shouldn't even focus on the freaking audio at all right now. It'll just confuse me. There's too much visual stuff to get right first. Trying to do two things at once, I'll be like, ah, I don't know which one to do. Yeah, so hopefully it works. Maybe that music just works and I'll keep it like that. That's the same music from the other one, the other cutscene of the tower. So I'm trying to get it sine out this time. This time it should. Well, maybe it just needs to move more overall, eh? Like, what if we had another 100 there? And another like 100 there. And sine out. Yeah. Maybe just linear. Ease none. Let's try no easing. Nice, right on. Cool. Right. Blue and red. There's also red versus blue. And there's so many other red versus blue things. Oh yeah, it's totally jittery. Well, it's supposed to be jittery. The tower's supposed to jitter there at first to get to, because it's like going, but it needs to not jitter as long, so less of these repeats, more like I'd guess 50 repeats or so. And then after a while, it's like it's done. I wanted the foreground or maybe the background clouds to sync more. Think so. Let's try negative 50 there. Yeah, so I really got to redraw the bottom of it. It doesn't look good at all. Oh, and this should move a little more. Actually, this is starting to look right. I'm gonna check this in so far. All right, well, a couple more tweaks, and then that's gonna be it for a day. A couple more tweaks. I think I wanna work on the clouds. The clouds didn't quite, they were too high at first. The second foreground, this one moves negative 100, but starts at 50. Maybe that should start at zero. I ruined it. Is it the wrong one? Ah, what? What happened? Oh, did I change? I did change something right there, huh? Oh, what the hell? How did that happen? All right, I'm thinking this. Yeah, the whole screen could jitter. We could do a couple more jitters there. Okay, so that definitely was the right direction to move that. Oh man, I should maybe make this so it goes straight into this instead of having to speed up time to get to it. Whoops. Oh yeah, all the background needs to do is rise some more. is going the wrong way. Oh. I want all of these to go positive. What's four? Four is the tower. Okay, so let's try moving all of these into positive. Yeah, that would look cool, but definitely not that much. Definitely should be some smoke and other stuff. Man, I can't do any more right now. Such tedious work. Change one little thing, takes a second to try it. This will turn out good though. Thanks, Ad. Yeah, this will probably take another couple hours of refinement to get it to look just right, you know, especially that part where the ground from the tower is there needs to be something covering that up, maybe. Like, maybe the parallax should happen so the clouds covered up that the bottom of the ship more. Or the tower. But anyways, I gotta take a break. I've been staring at this too long. Yeah, right, yeah. I mean, I could maybe put up some smoke, lots of smoke. That would probably be a good thing to add anyways. Yeah. Yeah, and then I'll have to animate Zero in that scene, and also I need to do some custom audio, maybe based on that same audio there, it's already there. Just like change it so it's a little bit different. But there'll be custom audio for everything there. Not only that scene, but the scene before it and the scene after it. So there'll be kind of like a track of music that plays at that point. That kind of ties together all those cutscenes. Yeah, so that's the vision. Yeah. Well, anyways. Yeah, totally. It'll be, yeah, good endgame stuff. All that custom music. Yeah. All right, y'all. Well, hope y'all have a great night. Thanks for watching. Catch y'all next time.